Hello dear students, we are going to discuss today on the second part of filtration and clarification. The basic object of the present lecture is to make students aware of the fundamentals of filtration, filter aids and filter medium. The lecture also gives detailed description of different type of filters like filter press, filter leaf, rotatory filter, meta filter and membrane filters. Seeing what is the filtration, it may be defined as the process of separating suspended matter from the liquids by forcing the liquid through a porous membrane which serves to retain the solid particles. The material collected on the porous membrane is called as filter cake. When the solids are present in a very low concentration, not exceeding 1% weight by volume, the process of its separation from liquid is called clarification. Clarification is generally employed when the contaminating material is finely subdivided, amorphous or colloidal in nature. Difficulties in filtration are generally of two types: low rate of flow and inadequate clarification. If the nature of solids to be filtered out is such as to form an open or porous cake, there is little difficulty in filtration and generally little trouble in obtaining satisfactory clarification. If, however, the solids are colloidal or gelatinous or tend to form non-porous cake, then filtrations become difficult. When with many materials, it is hard to obtain the requisite degree of clarification and rate of flow may be undesirably low. So what are filter aids? A filter aid is a material which serves to obtain or improve clarification or increases the rate of filtration or both. Diatomaceous silica is the most widely used type of filter. The fundamental function of the filter aid is to provide a porous cake structure. This is built up simultaneously with the deposition or retention of the suspended particles. The particles of filter aid must form a rigid skeleton or lattice structure which is capable of entraining the gelatinous or fine particles of unfiltered liquid and yet leave the channels in the filter cake through which the pure liquid thread of its suspended matter may pass at a rate and under such pressure differentials as are practical economically. The filter aid particles should be of such character as to remain suspended in the liquid prior to the filtration step and must be microscopic inside to provide cakes which will filter out the small particles of colloidal suspensions. The object of the filter aid is to prevent the medium from becoming blocked, to form an open porous cake, so reducing the resistance to flow of filtrate. In addition, a filter aid must be free from objectionable impurities such as soluble salts, organic matter, coloring matter, taste or odor imparting bodies, gritty particles, etc. It must also be inert or unreactive in the material being filtered. Seeing the various application methods of filter aid, the filter is used by three methods. First is the body mix method. The filter aid used in the concentration 0.0 to 4% weight by volume is mixed with the main slurry to be filtered. The slurry containing the filter aid is then filtered. The second one is the pre-coat method. If the pressure drop is very high, then the method is preferred. A layer of filter aid up to a suitable thickness is first formed by the filtration of filter aid and then the slurry is filtered. The third one is the special pre-coat method. It is used in rotatory drum filter. The filter aid slurry is first filtered while the scraper knife is removed. Once the filter aid cake, that is known as the pre-coat of the desired thickness, is formed, the main slurry is filtered. This time scraper knife is fitted, it scrapes the cake along with the small thickness of the pre-coat. Did you understand filter media? The filter media act as a mechanical support for the filter cake and is responsible for the collection of solids. It should have the following characteristics. It must be capable of delivering a clear filtrate at a suitable production rate. It must withstand mechanical stresses without rupturing or being compressed. No chemical or physical interaction with the components of the filtrate should occur. It must retain the solid without plucking at the start of filtration. Sterile filtration imposes a special requirement since the pore size must not exceed the dimensions of bacteria or spores. Example of filter media commonly used are woven filters. These include a wire screening, fabrics of cotton, wool, nylon, etc. Wire screening, example stainless steel, is durable, resistant to plugging and easily cleaned. Cotton is a common filter, however, nylon is superior for pharmaceutical use since it is unaffected by molds, fungus, bacteria and has negligible absorption properties. Seeing the non-woven filters, filter paper is the most common filter medium since it offers controlled porosity, limited adsorption characteristics and has a very low cost. Membrane filters, on the other hand, are basic tools for microfiltration, useful in the preparation of sterile solution. These filters are made by casting of various esters of cellulose or from nylon, Teflon, polyvinyl chloride, etc. The filter is a thin membrane with millions of pores per square centimeter of filter surface. Porous plates, these include perforated metal or rubber plates, natural porous materials such as stone, porcelain or ceramics and sintered glasses. The classification of filter. Filter can be classified as follows and it is based on the external forces. Pressure filters, plate and frame filter presses and metal filter, vacuum filter, filter leaf, centrifugal filters. Now the classification based on operation of the filtration, we have continuous filtration in which the discharge and the filtrate are separated steadily and uninterrupted. Whereas the discontinuous filtration, the discharge of filtrate solid is intermittent. Filtrate is removed continuously. The operation should be stopped to collect the solids. Now we'll see the classification which is based on the nature of filtration. The first is cake filters. They remove large amount of solids. Clarifying filters, they remove small amount of solids. Cross flow filters feed of suspension flows under the pressure at a fairly high velocity across the filter medium. Now what is filter press and filter leaf? They play very important role in filtration and clarification. The first we look forward for the filter press. This press is made up of two type of units, plates and frames, with a filter medium, usually filter cloth, between the two. The frame is open with an inlet for the slurry, while the paste has a grooved surface to support the filter cloth and with the outlet for the filtrate. Principle of operation includes: the slurry enters the frame marked by two dots from the feed channels. The filtrate passes through the filter medium onto the surface of the plate marked by one dot, while the solids from a filter cake in the frame. The filtrate then drains round the surface of the plate between the protections on the surface and escapes from the outlet. Filtration is continued until the frame is filled with the filter cake. When the process is stopped, the frame is emptied and the cycle restarted. In practice, large number of plates and frames are arranged alternatively and clamped in a supporting structure. This gives a number of filtration units operating in parallel and a filtration area as large as necessary. The thickness of the cake can be varied by using frames of different thicknesses. Plates and frames may be made in various metals to provide resistance to corrosion or prevent metallic contamination of the product. Non-metals avoid this problem and many have the advantage of lightness as reinforced plastics. Certain varieties of wood are materials of construction provided the press is kept wet at all times to avoid shrinkage. There are various advantages which includes: construction is very simple and a wide variety of material can be used as cast iron, stainless steel, hard rubber or plastic. It provides a large filtering area in a relatively small floor of space. The capacity being variable according to the thickness of the frames and the number used. The strong construction permits the use of considerable pressure differences up to about 20 bars. Efficient washing of the cake is possible. Operation and maintenance is simple because there are no moving plates. Filter cloth are easily renewable. Because all joints are external, any leaks are visible and do not contaminate the filtrate. We have certain disadvantages with this, which includes it is a batch filter. The filter press is an expensive filter. The emptying time, the efforts involved, and the wear and tear on the cloths resulting in high cost. Operation is critical as the frame should be full, otherwise washing is insufficient and the cake is difficult to remove. The filter press is used for slurries containing less than 5% of solids. Now seeing what is filter leaf. The filter leaf consists of a frame enclosing a drainage screen or a groove plate. The whole unit is covered with filter cloth. The outlet for the filtrate connects to the inside of the frame. The frame may be of any shape, circular, square or rectangular. Principles of operation. The filter leaf is immersed in the slurry. The receiver and vacuum screen system connected to the filtrate outlet. The slurry may be pumped under pressure. Each leaf has a centrally located neck at its bottom, which is inserted into a manifold that collects the filtrate. The leaf is constructed with ribs on both sides to allow free flow of filtrate towards the neck and is covered with coarse mesh screens that support the finer woven metal screens or filter cloth that restrain the cake. A typical example is the Sweetland filter, where it will be seen that the vessel is cylindrical and arranged so that it is supported by the upper part and the lower part can be swung away. This permits the cakes to be discharged by the compressed air without removing the filter leaves from the vessel. Advantages include the slurry can be filtered from any vessel and the cake can be washed simply by immersing the filter in the vessel of water. Removal of the cake is facilitated by the use of reverse airflow. The pressure difference may be contained with a vacuum or by using pressure up to the order of 8 bars. The area can be varied by employing a suitable number of units. Various applications are, the leaf filter is most suitable if the solid content of the slurry is not too high, about 5% maximum. A higher proportion results in the excessive non-productive time while the filter is being emptied, and provided this is observed with cost operating the filter. Seeing what is rotatory continuous filters, metafilters and membrane filters. Rotatory continuous filters, the drum rotates slowly about the horizontal axis and is partially submerged in the slurry reservoir so that each unit passes through the various zones. The number of the drum is covered with the filter medium and a vacuum is maintained below the medium on the inside of the drum. Liquid is sucked through the filter medium and solid in the feed are retained on the medium. Filtration is followed by cake washing and dewatering. The outlet of the leaf is connected to compressed air which detaches the cake from the filter medium. If the cake is not completely removed, this can be achieved by scraping with a knife. The commonest form in the use in the pharmaceutical industry is the rotatory drum filter. The filter units have the shape of the longitudinal segments of the periphery of the cylinder. Each filter unit is rectangular in shape with a curved profile so that the number can be joined up to form a drum. Each unit has a perforated metal surface to the outer part of the drum and is covered with the filter cloth. Appropriate connections are again made from each unit through a rotating valve at the center of the drum. Special attachments may be included for particular purposes. Cake compression rollers may be fitted if the cake shrinks and the cracks are it dries out. It compresses the cake to a homogeneous mass to improve the efficiency of washing as the cake passes through the washing zone, or to aid drainage of wash water as the cake passes through the drying zone. A pre-coat filter may be used where the solids of the slurry block the filter cloth. The pre-coat of filter aids is deposited on the drum prior to the filtration process. Thus, the scraper knife removes the solid filtered from the slurry together with the amount of the pre-coat, the knife advancing slowly as the pre-coat is removed. Various advantages are: the rotatory filter is automatic and is continuous in operation, so the cost is very low. The filter has a large capacity, the area of the filter as represented by a Darcy's law is infinity. Suitable for use with concentrated slurries since the system removes the cake continuously. Variation of the speed of rotation enables the cake thickness to be controlled, and for solids that form an impenetrable cake, the thickness may be limited to less than 5 mm. If the solids are coarse, forming a porous cake, the thickness may be 100 mm or more. There are some disadvantages, which includes: the system is complex with many moving parts and it's very expensive. The cake tends to crack due to air drawn through by the vacuum system, so that washing and drying are not efficient. Being a vacuum filter, the pressure difference is limited to 1 bar and hot filtrates may boil. The rotatory filter is suitable only for straightforward slurries, but if the solid form an impermeable cake or will not separate cleanly from the cloth, it will be less satisfactory. Seeing the various uses of the rotatory filter, the filter is most suitable for continuous operations on large quantities of slurry, especially if the slurry contains considerable amount of solids, that is in the range of 15 to 30%. Examples of pharmaceutical application includes collection of calcium carbonate, magnesium carbonate and starch, and the separation of mycelium from the fermentation liquor in the manufacture of antibiotics. Metafilter. The metafilter consists of a grooved drainage rod on which is packed a series of metal hinges. These rings, usually of stainless steel, are about 15 mm inside diameter and 22 mm outside diameter and a 0.8 mm in thickness, with a number of semicircular projections on one surface. When the rings are packed together, all the same way up, and tightened on the drainage rod with a nut, channels are formed that tapers from about 250 micrometer down to 25 micrometer. One or more of these packs is mounted in a vessel, and the filter may be operated by pumping in the slurry under pressure or by the application of reduced pressure to the outlet side. Advantages of metafilter includes: it have strength that high pressures can be used with no danger of busting the filter medium. As there is no filter medium, the running costs are low and it is a very economical filter. The metafilter can be made from materials that can provide excellent resistance to corrosion and avoid contamination of the most sensitive product. Removal of the cake is effectively carried out by backflushing with water. Various uses of metafilters are: the small surface area of the metafilter restricts the amount of solid that can be collected. This, together with the ability to separate very fine particles, means that the metafilter is used almost for clarification purposes. The strength of metafilter permits the use of high pressures, that is up to 15 bars, making the method suitable for viscous liquids also. Seeing the membrane filters, these filters are microporous plastic films with specific pore size ratings, also known as screen, sieve or microporous filters. Membrane retain particles or microorganisms larger than these pore size primarily by surface capture. Membrane filters are made up of cellulose acetate, mixed cellulose esters and nylons. These filters should be of sufficient strength, chemically and biologically inert and thermostable. Uses of membrane filter includes: for many laboratory application including filter sterilizing biological fluids, microbiology contamination analysis and air monitoring. For filtration of enzyme solutions, diagnostic cytology, receptor binding studies. Sterilization and clarification of strong acids and many other solvents incompatible with other membranes. It is also used for HPLC sample preparation. filter, sterilize and clarify aqueous and organic solvent solutions including buffers, microbiological and tissue culture solutions. Now we move to conclude the lecture, as a filtration is a process of separation of solid from a fluid by passing the same through a porous medium known as filter medium. Filter aids are added that help in filtration. Numerous type of filters are available that can be either surface type or the depth type filters. Some commercially used filters are discussed. Hope you all enjoyed this informative lecture. Thanks for your attention. Keep studying and goodbye.